My lord, Lady Tewkesbury is here to see you.
Very well, send her in.
Edmund, at last we are together. I have at long last resolved to speak my deepest secret. Edmund, my God, I love thee. I do so love thee.
You mock me.
Why, Edmund, nothing could be further from the truth. I adore you. I worship you.
You mock me.
Mock you? Why, Edmund, how could I mock so noble and honorable a man? A man who is so completely unworthy of mockery.
If you truly love me, then why do you insist on mocking me so? Away with you!
No!
Go!
No.
Leave at once!
Very well. But if you will not requite my love, I will kill myself!
You mock me! And I will not be mocked! The insolence and bold effrontery! She was mocking me, was she not?
Oh, yes, your lordship. I was crimson with rage at the egregious impertinence of her ball impudence. Weren't you, Thomas?
Oh, yes, yes. The brazen audacity of her tongue was surpassed only by her derisive hauteur.
I thought so.
My lord, the royal artist has completed his portrait of your lordship. He seeks your approval.
Show him in. Master, I humbly present the fruit of 2 years' labor. The royal portrait!
My lord is not pleased with the portrait.
You mock me.
Your lordship, quite the contrary. The portrait celebrates your noble bearing. I have put you in uniform to capture the lion heart that beats within your heroic breast.
Will this mockery never cease? Away with you. If there is one thing I cannot abide, it is being mocked. Now go! And take your grotesque caricature with you. I will not be mocked! Was I wrong?
As ever, no, Your Highness. His most contemptuous rendering was a taunt on canvas.
Would you say so, Thomas?
Oh, yes, yes, yes. The effrontery of his derisive painting was surpassed only by his brazen gall.
Exactly.
My lord, Nigel, the groundskeeper, seeks a word with you.
If he must.
This way. Excuse me, Squire, I hate to bother you. But we've been having some problems with some poachers. We've noticed 12 wild pigs missing and several pheasants as well. I would like to request a detachment of your guard to help find the transgressors.
You mock me.
I'm sorry, Squire.
You mock me.
As I was saying, Squire, if we could deal with this poacher matter, then...
I find it most baffling that one so low would hope to gain from mocking one so high.
Excuse me, Squire, I don't mean to talk out of turn, but with respect to this mockery, sir, I would imagine if anyone was mocking you, it would be the poachers themselves.
They mock me, but not to my face! Now, away with you!
Right away, Squire!
I will not be mocked! I grow weary. The moon is out. I say the moon is out, and yet it is day. The moon mocks me, and I will not be mocked.
Yes, the crescent moon dare not show its full face, lest its lunar contempt be seen for what it is, a brazen panoply of effrontery. Thomas?
Oh, yes, of course, the impudence of the moon's bold audacity.
I will retire now to my chamber, where there are only my bed and my dreams to mock me.
You mock me.
You never not be mocked.
I do not want to mock you.
You mock me.
I will not mock you.